The market, as well as your assessment of the asset quality, seems to have a disconnect at this point. How would you state the 10,000 crore rupees of watch list that you have given and 20,000 crore rupees of sub-investment grade of assets in your total book?
So if you look at the sub-investment grade book that we put out over there, it's a very clinical, objective exercise, Nisha. It's not as if that there is any discussion involved in terms of what we put there, what we don't put there. Anything that trips the rating on that particular portfolio just goes into that. So I don't think that we were selective in terms of putting that book out there. Every account that was BB and below in terms of the rating found expression in that list. And I don't think that that has fundamentally changed. Coming to the watch list of 10,000 crores, I mean, how did we cull that out from the total, sub-investment grade book? We saw exposures where there were repayments coming up, where we thought that the cash flows may be insufficient to service those. And we decided to just flag them preemptively. So I think what we did actually was to go out there, be proactive, be very transparent, and put it out there much in advance, rather than wanting to, you know, hold back some disclosures. So when you say that there's a disconnect in terms of, you know, the book that we put out there vis-a-vis what the market perception is, it's something that, you know, I find a little difficult to explain.
So there has been a UBS report, and most of the other analysts who have really analyzed your company post your results have all mentioned that there is an uncertainty about the asset risk in the assets that you have in the book. Now, there are several numbers which are much higher than what you have put out. Is there an internal thinking on also taking a much more cautious approach and in the present environment to overhaul your internal systems as well, Ravneet?
So I think a lot of what we, you know, disclosed during the quarter four results was a move towards more prudential accounting, a move towards more openness and transparency. And that's the reason why we actually put out a watch list. So we've always had a sub-investment grade book out there, but for the first time we put out a watch list. And not only did we put out a watch list, we also went ahead and took some contingency provisions on that. So I think what that really shows is a desire on our part, an intent on our part, to be very open in terms of our engagement and be very transparent.